So somebody said, can we have non-US employees in our GCC, GCC high environment and still be compliant?
We get this question a lot. We work with a lot of very large organizations and then a lot of organizations on the manufacturing side that have to bring in non-US persons as part of their facilities that they have. So long story short, yes. So you can have non-US persons in GCC high. You can technically have them in GCC. However, GCC, you can't hold export control data. So that kind of problem goes away, if you will. GCC high, you can hold export control data. And all contractually Microsoft's agreeing to is that they will not have non-US persons on their side of the fence, right? Supporting the tenant. However, you, through permissions, through what they call ABAC, attribute-based access control, you can set up and govern an environment where non-US persons and US persons sit in the same tenant. You just restrict their ability to access. Now, one layer above that, when you start looking at IT admins, global admins, people with any kind of administrative capability that would give them the ability to see export control data, that's where the problems start really happening. Because outside of going and getting export control licenses for these people, you basically just cannot have them as administrators in your tenant any longer if they have the ability to access export control data. If they're just accessing Intune information that doesn't have the ability to remote connect or query information that is export control, that's one thing. But if they're administering Exchange, SharePoint, OneDrive, Teams, again, anything with the ability to actually see that information, that's where it becomes problematic. So long story short, you can have it in there, but you have to have a very, very robust governance structure in order to make sure that that happens without being in violation of ITAR or EAR.